In today's video, I'm going to show you guys 30 tips and tricks on the map Chalet. And if you guys would like to suggest the next map we do in next week's video, make sure to leave a comment down below. Now for the question of the day, what platform do you guys play Siege on? Let me know down in the comments below, but anyways, let's get right into the video. Starting off with tip number one, if you guys are defending the Master and Office objective, make sure you guys bring a shield up and place it on top of the piano. The reason for this is you could very easily contest the piano with double door, and you can of course just put a couple ADSs in front of it to help cover from any explosives. But you can contest this double door in front of you, but you can also use the shield as cover while you contest the K9 door or anybody running into office from that office breach. Now, the one downside to this is you can actually get wallbanged through the piano if you shoot right above the keyboard and they hit the right spots. You will get hit through the piano. So that is one thing to look out for, as you guys can see. But no matter what, it is still a very strong spot to play. Moving on to tip number two, I want to show you guys some vertical lines of sight that you can make for the Master and Office objective. So of course you can just open up right above the trophy window, but if there's people rappelling on solar windows, you can't really peek that. So if you guys break this plant pot in the corner of the top solar stairs, you can shock on the floor right around where I do, and this will allow you to see the trophy window, as you guys can see here. So you can contest the trophy window from above without being exposed to the two solar windows. Now besides that, if we make our way into bathroom, you can shock on the floor right around where I do next to the bathroom door, and that'll allow you to see anybody coming up the west main stairs from the basement. So it's good to watch not only the bottom west main, but you can also see anybody coming out of that dining door into west main. Now, making our way downstairs, if you guys are inside of wine cellar and vault up onto this box holding these two barrels, you can then shock on the floor right around where I do next to this support beam, and this will actually see anybody walking into that fireplace front door. So anybody trying to enter in that part of the map, trying to sludge the floor, buck the floor, open above the objective, you can kind of catch them before they even get into the building. When it comes to defending the bar and games objective, make sure you guys open up the library hatch, because from the safety of the objective, you can actually very easily contest the library double window hop-in from down below. And if you guys are defending that from downstairs, you're already holding the line of sight. As soon as they hop on the window, it should be a free kill. And the good thing about this is you're not exposed to any other angles, and you can also cover the single library window hop-in. So if you can shotgun the roof right where I do, you can actually prone behind the pool table and contest anybody vaulting in through that window. If you have a shotgun, this should be a free kill as well. So you can help cover the two windows for your teammates playing upstairs. There's actually another way to watch the single library window hop, and if you guys are inside of bar stock, shock on the top of the wall. This is actually above the reinforcement. You can see as they vault through the window, they will land right in front of your line of sight. The only downside to this is if the attackers somehow get the library control without you guys being able to get any picks, they will be able to use those holds against you and peek into bar stock from inside of library. So I don't really recommend doing this, but I did want to show you guys nonetheless. Now, if you guys are dealing with people outside of the bathroom windows on the Master and Office objective, you can very easily jump out of the mudroom window and contest them. Now, for those of you that like to spawn peek, if you guys go into solar, you're going to get a vault prompt onto the plant pot here, and then all you're going to do is break the floating pot and hit the top part of this window on solar. You can actually see people running from the campfire spawn towards the solar windows, so definitely give this one a try. Just a quick reminder, if you guys are enjoying these tips and tricks videos, make sure to leave a like on the video and hit that subscribe button and notification bell if you guys have not already done so. But anyways, let's get back into it. Making our way back downstairs, I want to point out that there is a drone hole between wine cellar and blue. I'm sure a lot of you know this is here, but you don't really understand how useful this can actually be. So if you guys are defending the wine cellar objective, you can use this to see how far people are pushing in through blue. Now you do want to be careful, the attackers can use this against you. But if they are turning that corner in from elbow in blue, you can see the bottom of their feet, and you can use that as a visual cue to know how far they are in blue and use that to contest them as they swing the wine cellar door. Now, this next tip is going to be for any roamers on the basin objective. If you guys open up the window above Snowmobile Garage, you can then shock on the floor right around where I do. It'll open up a pretty small line of sight through the floor for anybody that is roaming on the top floor to contest people outside of that Snowmobile Garage. Now, it's not the easiest spot to get a kill from, but at the very least, you can do some damage on anybody outside of Snowmobile. And from the attacker's point of view, it's kind of a hard angle to hit, and it's a pretty common spot that the attackers like to kind of sit in when they're peeking the breach. And as you can see, it is a pretty tight angle from top down. Now, moving on from that, if you guys are defending this objective, it's pretty common to hide behind the bomb chassis once the wall gets open to contest the left side of the breach. But this is pretty obvious, and you might get pre-fired off of it, but if you guys actually go up on the stairs, you can see through the bomb to that same angle that you would typically be holding from the bomb chassis. And it's a lot less obvious. If you're peeking the side of the bomb chassis, it's pretty obvious, but if you're peeking between the bomb, you can see it's a lot harder to really tell and to really win that gunfight. So we have a pretty cool nitro for you guys on the solar window. So you can rip open the right side solar window, you can break the glass so you can hear the other side of the window, but you're gonna line up with the right side of this window on the wall here. You're then gonna line up with the center of the solar window, you're gonna prone, and then put your crosshair right around here, and then you're gonna throw it. And as you guys can see, it'll break through the glass, it'll go to the other side, and actually lands at the bottom of the two solar windows. So this is great to kind of catch anybody trying to rappel up to the windows, which is sort of why I said break the glass, because you can hear the person try to rappel up. So you can pop that nitro mid-air if they are already on the rappel. Now I have another nitro for you guys inside of kitchen. This will be able to nitro anybody on the big window. So you're going to vault up onto the counter, crouch, look straight up as high as you can, and then line up with the top part of the support beam on the side of the wall. And then you're going to go ahead and just throw it. So you can actually pop this mid-air to catch the person on that master window rappel, or you can actually just let it fall all the way to the ground, because this actually lands right outside of the trench door on the trench stairs. As you guys can see, anybody coming out or coming down from the trench stairs to the trench door can get hit by this nitro, and you can actually break the glass on the master window to hear anybody outside of trench. Now moving on to some Cade spots. Instead of just throwing the Cade on the middle of both these walls, let's actually throw it up onto the roof. So you're going to throw your first Cade right around where I do, and that'll get both of the walls very, very easily. And the second one, we're going to actually throw it from inside of this library hallway. And I know you would think, like, why would you throw it on the other side? But it's pretty difficult to get this Cade. Obviously, they could just nade it or use some sort of soft destruction to get it. But realistically, other than that, they have to shoot it, and it's sort of not really well known for you to throw the Cade on that side of the wall. So if they do go underneath, they only can get the first Cade. They can't get the second Cade, but the good thing about the first Cade being on the roof is if they go downstairs and use any form of soft destruction, like a nade and impact, they don't actually destroy the Cade. They have to peek through the holes in order to actually shoot the Cade off the wall. Now we have another Cade spot. Now this is the more well-known one, but to Cade both of the wine cellar walls facing the big garage. You want to go into dining, you're going to shotgun, or you can use your pistol to open up the table, and you're going to throw your Cade all the way to the other side of the table. And as you guys can see, if we make our way downstairs, you'll be able to Cade both of the two back walls facing big garage. This is a little bit more well-known, but you guys should definitely still try it out. When defending the bar in game's objective, it's pretty common for you to try and defend the library, and in doing so, you need to figure out a way to slow the attackers down. So you can make feet holes across the office wall that leads to the canine balcony, and you can actually get onto the fireplace stairs and use this to contest anybody that is inside of office trying to apply pressure in piano hallway to then push into library. So similar to the last tip, you can actually open up above the dining wall in this case, even if you reinforce it. So I recommend reinforcing this wall when you're defending the master objective, because you do have a couple extra reinforcements. And then what you're going to do is you're going to vault up onto this little half wall inside of dining, and you can contest people going up and down the main stairs inside a fireplace. Now, another reason to play dining when the site is master and office is because, like I said, you do have some extra walls. So I'll reinforce these just to kind of give you an idea. But you open up the left side of the top of the wall, and this will allow you to nitro anybody in the most common default plant spot behind the half wall inside of office. And if we make our way upstairs, as you can see, if we get into the default plant spot behind the half wall and we blow that nitro that I threw a little bit ago, you can see that it will nitro the person behind the default plant. So it's always good to play downstairs on this objective, because this is just a free way to deny the typical default plant. Now this next one's a little bit harder to hit, but it's going to be another nitro spot. If you guys open up the snowmobile window and open up the floor right in front of it, you will then be able to nitro outside of snowmobile garage from inside of snowmobile garage. So you guys just kind of give it some momentum. You want to make sure you give it enough momentum, because it has to go over that balcony right outside of this window, and it'll land right next to the snowmobile outside of the garage. Hey, what's up guys? Sorry to interrupt the video, but I want to talk about today's video sponsor, and that is Root Insurance. If you guys are like me, or you're just getting to the adulthood age, you're definitely going to need some car insurance, and car insurance is not cheap by any means. But with Root Insurance, you guys can save up to $900 a year. All you guys got to do is check out the link down in the description below, and you can easily just get the app on your phone. Anyways, let's get back into the video. Now, moving on to the Echo, we have quite a few yokai spots for you guys to use. There's so many rafters on the top floor of the map, and this is just going to be one of those. So you use the support beam here to kind of cover your yokai drone. And then when somebody goes into the default plant, you jump your drone up, you shoot them off the plant, and then you hide your yokai again. And as you can see, you can't even see this yokai at all until you walk in. And even then, you have to walk into the objective deeper to even see this yokai. Now, besides that, there are some more rafters inside of Master, and we're going to use that to also do something similar to get some info inside of Master, but more importantly, be able to actually use our yokai. So You can pick any of these support beams. In this case, I'm going to go ahead and pick this one. And as you can see, I can watch anybody coming up these solar stairs. You can see them walk into master, and you can even jump your drone up to concuss them as they walk in if they're going for a plant or anything along those lines. Now, master and office are not the only spots that have rafters. You also have rafters inside of solar. So we're going to do the same thing inside of solar. And there are so many beams that you can use to kind of use for your yokai, but in this case we're going to go ahead and use this one because this one actually I feel like gives you the most info. You can see anybody coming up these solar stairs, you can see them push towards the master door. You can actually go around this other support beam as well, and you can go to the other side of it and you can see people pushing the actual bathroom door. So this just gives you so much info here. Now, you guys knew I had to throw in some vault cams in this video, but considering outside vault cams are not going to work anymore starting next season, I thought I would show you guys some pretty good inside vault cams for whatever objective you see fit. So the first one's going to be bottom fireplace under this light fixture. It's pretty well hidden, and it gives you all the info inside of fireplace. You can see top fireplace, the fireplace stairs going down to the basement. You can also see bar as well. So overall, a really good cam, probably for the basement objective or just to give you info inside of fireplace. As for our second vault cam, you're going to go ahead and throw it next to this deer statue, and it'll allow you to pretty much cover that. You don't see it coming down the blue stairs, but you can get really good info on blue stairs, people coming down blue stairs, pushing blue hallway, and you can see how far they go inside of blue hall. Now from there, we're going to make our way up the library stairs to the top, and we're going to go ahead and throw our vault cam into the corner here. Now you want to make sure it sticks to the south wall of the library hallway or the library staircase here, or else the debris will actually cover the visual line of sight. So I'll go ahead and shoot that one, but as you guys can see, if you get it on the right side of the wall or the correct side of the wall, you'll be able to see anybody coming up the library stairs, and more importantly, see people push the piano double door. Now besides that, we're going to go ahead and enter in the office. So this vault cam is going to be straight for just info on the plant, so we're going to throw it up in the rafters here. And this will just give you really good info on anybody running in to go for the actual plant. So you can't see this vault cam anywhere outside from canine balcony. You can't see it from the office wall being open. So you'll be able to see them walk in for the plant, and you'll be able to use that to know if you need a nitro below or anything like that. Now, the last vault cam I'm going to show you guys is going to be inside of solar. Now, there are so many different ways or different spots for you to use. In this case, I'm going to go ahead and throw it right above the solar stairs. You could see people come up the solar stairs. You could see them go towards master door, and you can also see them go towards the bathroom door from solar as well. So overall, a pretty good spot and good for any objective you need it. Now, moving on from there, if you guys are playing Maverick for the basement objective, make sure you pair up with someone. So as you map the top of the wall, you can have a teammate actually vault up on top of the snowmobile to peek the mav holes as you are mavving them, and you might be able to catch somebody rotating throughout the objective and catch them off guard. Now you can also rappel as well. I think rappelling is probably going to be better because you can see not only the connector side, but you can actually swing around and look at pretty much the entire snowmobile objective. So you guys saw how valuable the rafters were inside of solar with the vault cams, with the yokais, so we're actually going to use that with our drone on attack, and you can actually get there during the prep phase. And this could be good for a bar games attack where you need to know if you're going to get flanked on solar stairs or not. So you can just vault up your drone just like I do on the plant pots, and then you can just get it up in the rafters wherever you'd like. You can see the solar stairs, you can see where they, if they go to master door, if they go to bathroom door. So overall, a really good flank cam for you guys to set up if you guys need to watch solar stairs. I know we are Astralis R6, but make sure you guys check out the in-game store and get your hands on the Disrupt Gaming in-game weapon skins for the R4C, the LED5, and the two charms while you still can. Anyways, let's get back into the video. If you guys rappel outside of the mudroom window, you can actually get a pretty good angle onto the bathroom window, and you can watch as people rotate from bathroom into solar and vice versa. You might be able to get an early pick into the round. Now, it's pretty scary to peek the bathroom windows when you're on the balcony, but if you use these two support beams to kind of cover you from that library window or library hallway window, you definitely need to do that. But you can also get a pixel onto the bathroom window that leads to the piano slash office doorway, and you might be able to catch somebody kind of rotating around, but you do want to be careful though because the defenders could already be holding this angle and they will catch you before you can really catch them. When you're trying to go for a plant in the wine cellar objective, make sure you shoot this barrel because it allows you to tuck in a little bit deeper when going for the plant, and it'll hopefully make it a little bit harder for the defenders to swing wide and deny the plant, and hopefully your teammates can kind of cover you before they deny that plant. If you ever have to clear somebody out of top fireplace and they're hiding behind the actual fireplace pillar, and you guys are on canine balcony with nade, you can very easily bounce the nade off the top pillar on the top of the fireplace stairs, and if you guys cook it just right, let it bounce, it'll kill anybody behind the big pillar in the middle of top fireplace. Now, something else you guys can do on Canine Balcony is if you guys actually go onto the rappel on the east side, you can actually peek over this bookshelf here, so you can see people run from the top library stairs into library and vice versa. So you might be able to catch somebody off guard trying to kind of rotate around the library while your teammates are pushing them out. As you can see from the defender's point of view, if they're rotating up the library stairs towards the library connector, they will get caught off from this angle that you're holding. You can catch them going in, going out, or even vaulting over the staircase. Now, if you guys rappel onto the roof here, right where I am, you can actually see the top fireplace. And even if there's a shield there, you might be able to actually see the top of their head as they peek the shield. And you might be able to catch them off guard, not really expecting something like this. When attacking the basement objective, it's pretty common for you to try to open up this north wall inside of wine cellar, because you can use this as a super long angle to clear anybody rotating from connector into wine cellar. And you can always do this from deep inside a big garage. And if you guys open up the wall big enough and vault up onto the car, you can get an elevated angle on anybody kind of rotating around inside of wine cellar. And this will just be sort of an off angle to kind of catch them off guard. And last but not least, I want to show you guys all of the verticality you could have on the trophy slash solar areas. So if you guys buck right where I do, you can see the bottom of the solar stairs if they run up or down. It's good if you pair this with a nade on solar windows. You can nade the person on the stairs and he runs directly into your line of sight. Now from there, you can actually buck the solar portion of the map from the basement. So you just buck through the floor, you buck through two layers to actually clear it out. So you can clear the bathroom door side, you can clear behind the little half wall in the corner next to the default camera. You can pretty much clear anywhere inside of solar if you'd like. I recommend sitting in the custom lobby to kind of get every other line of sight, just kind of learn where they're at and everything. You can also shoot the default cam from down here, but just kind of learn where to buck from down below. But you can clear out every part of solar from downstairs, so you don't really have to get a lot of map control. You just take big garage and you can start clearing solar pretty easily. Now, if you guys enjoy the content I post on the Astralis channel, make sure to check out my socials, which are on screen right now, if you guys want to check out any of the other content that I make. But anyways, guys, that's going to be all for me. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you all enjoyed. If you did so, don't forget to leave a like on the video. And if you guys are new to the channel, consider hitting that subscribe button and notification bell so you guys don't miss a future video. But anyways, guys, I will catch you guys in the next one. Peace.